What's up, everybody? This is Mr. Second Passport. Today, after a couple weeks off, I'm coming back to you. I just spent a few weeks in the States working on a project and visiting family over the holidays. More on that in the next couple videos. Pretty interesting. Back where I live in Ecuador, and my time in the States just now just reminded me of how much I dislike, or you could even say hate, a lot of things about living in the U.S. Now, it is my home country, so I gotta put respect where it's due, and this video does remind me a lot of once when I was sitting in a Greyhound bus on a long-distance trip across the U.S., a Mexican guy sat next to me, and all he did was bitch about how much he hated the U.S. so much and how great Mexico was, and it annoyed me. Because, well, you know, all I wanted to say to him was, why don't you go back to Mexico then, you know? But you can't really say that in this case because, well, I'm out. You won't find me in the U.S. I don't live in the U.S. no more. You know, I did bounce, right? And secondly, I'm talking about very specific things. The U.S. as a whole is a real, real amazing place to be from and to live. But there's a few things that really irk me that we're going to cover in today's vid. And I'm also going to share how Ecuador beats the U.S. in all of these points. The first thing that really annoys me that I freaking hate about the U.S. is importantly the car culture. I really don't like the car culture of the U.S. Not so much the traffic. Traffic you can find everywhere. I've never seen worse traffic than in some foreign countries like New Delhi. Medellin, Colombia, you know, who would guess? I've seen worse traffic than I've ever seen in the U.S. But as far as the car culture, I just hate it. You know, you take your car down to the mailbox to get the mail, and you can't do anywhere. You can't do anything. You can't go anywhere without a car, and it's just annoying. I don't like it. In the U.S., in Ecuador, and pretty much all over the world, you really don't need a car. It's a luxury, but you don't need it, and I love that about living in South America. The second thing that I despise, that I freaking hate about living in the U.S., or life in the U.S., you could say, is the fast food culture. I know everybody's getting more and more like healthy and vegan and all that, little by little in the States, but still, you know, I mean, it's true, when you're working in the U.S., like I was for a couple weeks, that's literally all there is fast food. Do you want this fast food or do you want that fast food? If you don't have time to cook, you're either going to starve to death or eat some nasty fast food. And I just don't like the fast food culture of the U.S. And every time, you know, I saw cars lined up at these fast food places, so it's not like they're going anywhere anytime soon. Another big thing I hate about the States is every time I'm up there, the food, and maybe it has to go along with the fast food, but the food just puts pounds on like you wouldn't believe when I'm there, and it also makes me constipated as hell. And now down here in Ecuador, you know, I'm flowing like a faucet. No problem. Amaze me. The next thing I freaking hate about the U.S., is scraping cars off in the winter. You know, your hands get cold as shit. You don't want to wear gloves just for that and then carry them around the rest of the day when you don't really need them. But then when you're scraping your car off, your hands get cold as shit and it's just terrible. You break your windshield wipers and that's one thing I'm not going to miss living in South America. The next thing, I was in Cleveland where I'm originally from. That's where I spent the 3 weeks. Ice storms. I totally forgot about these, but these suck. You know, literally the whole world has to come to a stop and you can't drive in it and you can't go anywhere because you're living in a car culture. Nobody wants to deliver you any food because it's icy and scary out. It's just a bad thing that I'm not going to miss living in Ecuador. The next thing I absolutely freaking hate about the U.S., is the consumer culture. I was living with my brother and his new wife. They just got married. And it seemed like every single day, I was there for about 3 weeks, every single day, three, four packages arrived from Amazon or different sources at their doorstep. And It's just annoying, that whole consumer culture, you know, them buying pans for like 250 bucks, you know, that are supposed to be special or something. I despise it. I fucking hate it. And I'm glad that culture doesn't exist so much in Ecuador, that keeping up with the Joneses. It does a little bit in certain circles, of course, just like everywhere in the world, but I see it a lot more in the U.S. The next thing I absolutely hate about the U.S. is the customer service, but in general. There's a few shining stars out there, but generally it's dark night. I mean, when you're talking about customer service and having to even sometimes even find someone that can help you when you need something, and for them to actually like attend you kindly is another thing altogether. It just doesn't seem like a very pleasant place. People are just kind of going through the motions, and a lot of people working in customer service that probably shouldn't be doing that but are in it because they have to be, or you know, whatever. It's not for everyone. The next thing I freaking hate about the U.S. is when you actually have to find someone to do something. Like maybe you need a plumber to fix a sink, or a cleaner to clean your house. And if there's not a large immigrant population where you live, like in the more northern parts of the U.S., this can be a huge pain in the ass, like it was for me. People canceling on me, people wanting to charge me like $1,000, right, to come fix a toilet, you know, stuff like that. I'm used to living in South America where you can find someone real quick, someone reliable, and, you know, they'll come over and they'll charge you a decent, reasonable 10, 15 bucks if they're only there a couple minutes, and hey, there you go, see you later. The next thing I freaking despise or really hate about the U.S. is the big box store culture. Like, everything you need. Here's a hint of what I was doing. I was remodeling a house that I had bought basically online a couple years ago. Sight unseen, and in the Cleveland area, and every little thing that you need, you know, I really missed about Ecuador. You could just go to the corner store, the little corner hardware store. But in the States, every little thing you need, you got to go to these big box stores, park your car, walk a mile, walk inside, walk another mile until you can find, you know, this little thing that you need. The next thing I freaking hate about the U.S. is the whole pharmaceutical culture, and how you, like, you just turn on the TV maybe to watch a sports game, like in my case, and you're just bombarded with these horrible commercials. I totally forgot about these, about, hey, you need this pill in order to treat this thing, and the side effects, you know, are sudden death, possible hemorrhaging from the eyes, and possibly blood in the stool, and if you might have horrible cramps while you sleep, and blah 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 blah, and it just, the side effects can go on for like a minute, just the side effects, and then by the time the commercial's done, you think you literally have the disease they're talking about, and it's just a horrible thing. I wish they put some kind of law against it. You don't really get that horrible pharmaceutical in your face, you have this, you must take this, consumerism culture, pretty much all over the world except the U.S. The U.S. is probably the worst in that. The next thing I absolutely freaking hate about the U.S. is how intimidating the police are. You know, you're just driving down the freeway. I totally forgot about this, not living there for a while. You know, and there are these cops that just come out of nowhere. They're just sitting there parked, you know, like little alligators just waiting to pounce. And, it's intimidating, and you don't get that in the in a place like Ecuador, for instance, because, you know, if you get pulled over, you can get out your car and you can start negotiating the situation and probably get yourself out of it 9 times out of 10. But the you know, in the U.S., you know, you keep your hands on the wheel or you could get shot. The next thing I absolutely hate about the U.S. is the few buses there are. In like city buses and like Greyhounds, in a few cities in the U.S., not all, the bus systems are really bad. Like, I really hate having to take a bus in the U.S. This time I took one bus this trip in downtown Miami, and it was a horrible experience. just horrendous. There was almost a fight because one guy like tried to slide past another guy to go out the bus. I don't know. I just didn't like it. A lot of very conflictive, a lot of tension, and it's like, is this guy gonna about to pull out a gun and cap everyone on the bus? I don't know. I didn't like the experience. Okay. The next and last thing I absolutely fucking hate about the U.S. is how political it's gotten, especially since I left 10 years ago. It was always kind of conflictive, between the right and the left. But now it's really bad. I'm just driving around in Cleveland. You see little signs, RIP USA, with the date Biden won. Now I'm not really, honestly, I didn't even vote. I'm not very political on either side. I'm one of the few people left maybe like that, but I'm just not very political. But I didn't like how politicized it was. Seeing people putting those kind of signs in their yard turned me off. So that's it. I'm Mr. Second Password. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button below if you like this video and want to see more like this. Talk to you later.